looking to the hills has come, our help and our strength. Really, as in my Father, our help and our strength come from you. We just want to say thank you. We want to thank you for all you have done and all you're doing in our lives right now. We ask you to continue blessing us all in the blessing that we stand in the need of. We ask that the waiting congregation, we can receive the word from on high. Our prayer that something be said today to make their life better than the world before they come through these doors. My Father, we ask you to continue looking upon the sick and the shut in. You know who they are and where they are. You know the pain and ache they have, my Father. We know that you can heal. We just call on you to continue looking upon them. Oh, my Father, bless this church that we call First Baptist. Bless the one who's going to break the bread of life, Reverend Hampton. That you give him a word on how that he gives to be your faithfulness. Oh, my Father, we ask him to bless him from the White House to the left, to our house. That whatever they do it in the representation of the people that they serve. We thank you, my Father. And bless the troops overseas fighting war, those in the state fighting war. Realize, my Father, there are wars all around us. We just ask you to cover us, my Father, so there'll be no more. We can live in peace throughout our lives.
Oh, yeah.
We thank you, my Father. Say a blessing. We say a special prayer for our young people. Yeah. That you continue letting them look to the healing because they help and strength. Oh, realize, my Father, their health and their strength come from you. Lead them, guide them in the way you have them go. We thank you. My Father, we realize someone laid down last night. Wasn't able to answer the call. We ask that the bereaved family all over, my Father. Let them know that you're God and don't make mistakes. We give you all the honor and praise. My Father, we ask you to give us up all our sins, those seen and not seen by man. Realize, my Father, you that created us and not we ourselves. You find in the Father in our heart and our mind this day. You just remove it so we could be more like your Son, Jesus. We could walk, we could talk. We can do the things that Jesus has commanded us to do. Realize, my Father, we do that to the best of our ability. Our name will not be in vain. Then, my Father, prayer time is over. You have this all go. We ask for a place somewhere in your kingdom where we can serve you better there than we do here. Yes, and may that blessing we ask in your Son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
When all God's children get together, oh, what a time, what a time, what a time. We're gonna sit down by the banks of the river. What a time, what a time, what a time. When we come and we come get together.
have. What a time we will have. And we can have that time while we're here on earth. We don't have to wait till we get to heaven. We can have it right here on earth. Because we're Christians and we love Jesus Christ. And we have to make sure that we let everybody else know that as well.
Amen.
Good morning, saints.
Good morning.
And we give honor to God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
It is good to be in God's house one more time. Amen. 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 I was glad when it said unto me,
let us go into the house of the Lord.
In the house with the name attached, First Baptist Church. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. We're going to thank our deacons for getting us started this morning. Thank you so much. Brown will come with our prayer, and Minister Mathis will come with our scripture.
Amen.
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 Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let us pray. Oh God, you are amazing,
yes,
and we honor you.
Woo!
Your presence is a gift. And therefore, God, on this day, because the gift of your presence, we are here to lift up the name of Jesus. We thank you for this day. We thank you for another opportunity to worship you, oh God, because you are so worthy to be praised. God, we ask that you have thine own way in this place, oh God. Spirit move, Holy Spirit move, allow us to lift up our hands in worship, open our mouths in worship, because God, we give you thanks in all things, because surely goodness and mercy have followed us all of this week and all the days of our life. So God, in this worship service, we ask you to have thine own way. We adore you and we lift you higher. Bless this worship service. In Jesus' name, oh God, God bless and speak through the man of God as he preaches the word. God, continue to just fill us with your presence, oh God, as we continue to worship you, because you've been so good and so great and so wonderful. God bless our pastor, continue to strengthen him. God, as we continue and go forth in this worship service, we give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm always excited to share the words of the Lord with you.
Amen.
I'll be sharing with you this morning, John 3:16-17. And it reads, "For God so loved the world,
yes, Lord,
that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." And 17 reads, "For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world," oh hallelujah, "but to save the world through him." This is the word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Okay, we're not going to prolong it. We have an awesome preacher this morning. Married to beautiful Sharon Hampton, he is a man of God. He can preach, will preach, and he is going to preach. We ask you that you do your amens, Lord, that you pray for him and pray with him.
Amen.
But after this song, the next voice you will hear will be none other than Reverend Alfred Hampton. Hear ye him.
God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's so good to be in the house of God.
Amen.
I don't know about y'all, but if you don't have God, it wasn't no alarm clock. It wasn't a phone call, but it was just that touch of love that got me started. And I'm here again. So I'm glad to give him the praise, the glory, and the honor.
Amen.
And I thank Pastor White for the opportunity to bring forth the word this morning. We pray that he has a safe journey on his vacation.
Yes.
That you just lift him up and his family up and what God is doing in our lives. Sister A said we're going to get out of here about 11:30. I don't know what kind of clock she on, but it might be right somewhere in there. We're going to let God use us in a mighty way. We're going to have a good time with the Lord. I don't know about y'all, but I'm happy.
Yeah.
Let's start off by prayer. Father, Lord our God, we thank you once again for another opportunity to gather here in the house of worship. We ask that you use us in a mighty way, that you have your way in this service, Lord. Someone needs to hear a word from you, Lord, and it's me. Standing in the need of a word, Lord, that you speak to our hearts, our minds, our spirit, Lord, that we leave here a little different than we came in. Well, Lord, we came in to look for you, nobody else. You can show up for no other reason but because of you. You are worthy to be praised. Lord, if you don't do anything else, you've done more than enough. So we pause and say thank you. Pray for our pastor, Isaac Whitehead Jr. and his family, Lord. Give him traveling grace up and down the Davis Highway. Lord, we thank you for the word that you planted on our hearts and our minds, and you just lead God and direct us throughout this day, Lord. We love you, we honor you, and we praise you. In the Son, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I see we don't have a choir like y'all, like we usually do. We don't even have our musicians, but y'all are welcome to sing a song.
Amen.
Let's sing a song. Say, I love you.
Thank you, Lord.
I love you. Lord, I love you today.
Yes.
Because of who you are.
Yes.
In such a special way.
Yes.
That's why I praise you.
Right.
I lift you up.
Yes.
And I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. I love you. I love you. Lord, I love you today. You paid the price for me.
You're
back on Calvary. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled.
Amen.
My heart,
Amen.
My mind,
Amen.
My soul belongs to you.
Amen.
You paid the price for me.
Amen.
Back on Calvary.
Amen.
That's why I praise you.
Amen.
I lift you
Amen.
Up and I magnify your name.
Amen.
That's why my heart is filled with praise. Anybody praise him this morning? Join me in the gospel according to John. Real familiar passages.
Yes,
I think we all know this by heart. It's something we were taught as a child.
Yeah.
It's something that just went on my heart and God's been dealing with me. John 3:16-17, and these are the words you'll find there. It says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish but have everlasting life. 17 reads, for God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Amen. These are the words of Jesus. And if you will, pray with me as God uses me. I want to talk to you about the side effects of love.
Yes, all
right. I want you to repeat that with me, the side effects of love. I didn't hear you, the side effects of love. I don't know about y'all, but I've been dealing with this pandemic just like y'all have, and I found out there's a lot of side effects. We take shots, we take this, we take everything got side effects. You can eat this too many foods and too much drinking. Everything has a side effect. And I began to speak to this word. I thought about this thing. Love. That's a real tough thing. God is love. But there's some side effects. I don't know about y'all. I listened to a lot of music, and back in 2004, when American Idol, that was a star, some of y'all might remember, Fantasia. Y'all remember Fantasia?
Yeah.
Very awesome singer, and she won back in 2004. In 2004, she came out with an album. A little later on, after she won American Idol, and the title of her album was Free Yourself.
Yeah.
And her number one song off that album was Free Yourself. And it basically said, if you don't want me,
hey,
don't talk to me. I know y'all ain't with that, right? Some of y'all don't even know about Tayshia, but Tayshia was going through it. Her sons were talking about her life. And she was talking to some people that if you don't want me, don't talk to me. And then later on in life, she had some old trials and storms, and her sons would come and tell about her life story. But I found out in 2013, I'm still listening to some of these love songs. Man, Tayshia came out with a song, and it says, I like how she put it. She was real. She said, the side effects of you. In this song, she was talking about a lot of different things. I just want to read a few of the lyrics that came from this song. It says, so now I'm taking 3 a day to help me smile. She's talking about pills. She said, they said I wouldn't wait and try it for a while, so I've been ignoring the symptoms and the small print on the back of the prescription. He said, what am I gonna do? Says fever's over 98, you hold me and my body shakes. See, nobody told me the side effects of you. She goes on to say, losing balance, falling down, sleepless nights, whatever you're around, nobody told me the side effects of you. I double-checked the recommendation dose, cause recently my headaches got worse. Sometimes even part of me is shaking. It is the right pill that I'm taking. What am I gonna do? She goes on to say, fever over 98, you hold me and my body shakes. See, nobody told me the side effects of you. She goes on to say, sleepless nights, whenever you're around, nobody told me the side effects of you. She even said, you're supposed to take away the pain, but it hurts the same, and it's getting harder. I thought you were taking care of me, but I can't breathe, and it's getting harder. The side effects of you. Man, Tayshia was telling us some things here. But we want to talk about the side effects of love.
Come on, right?
And I don't know about y'all, there's a lot of things that happen in love, amen? We got to realize, we're not talking about earthly love, we're talking about godly love. These are the words of Jesus. Let us know what God did. The side effects. All right. What are the side effects? Y'all, some of y'all smokers or ex-smokers on cigarette packs, there's a warning label. It tells you this is dangerous to your health. And you still light up and keep on going. The side effects, amen. And when you get your prescription from the doctor, they give you a list of stuff that these pills may cause and make you do. Side effects. And you have to read it and say, well, okay, I took this pill, but now my side is hurting, my back is hurting, my leg. Why are all these things? Side effects. We take one thing for the other.
Yeah.
There are side effects from food, amen? Yeah. They can cause all kind of things. They can make you lose your hair.
Yeah.
Look at sad. Stuff that make you lose your hair. Stuff that hair grow places that I'm supposed to grow. Side effects of life, amen? But the side effects of love is something good. Something you didn't even deserve. You didn't see it coming, but God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son. That we may have life and have life more abundantly. But the Word of God talks about love when he talks about God. God loved us so much in spite of all the mess we do. Whatever you did last night, last week, you still got a side effect. He woke you up this morning. You know that? Reminds us in his writing of love in 1 Corinthians. He tells us about love. And sometimes we wonder, people say love hurts. No, love doesn't hurt. No, you might feel some pain here and there, but that's not a hurt. That's a good feeling, amen. I don't know why y'all, when someone tell me they love me and they're sincere about it, oh man, it's such a good feeling. You know when someone loves you, but God commands us to love you one another. He didn't say you had to like each other, he said love. And love is an action word that makes you do something. It ought to make you feel a little different this morning.
Yeah.
This morning when God first says the side effect, what is it? Side effect that woke you up, the side effect that let rain. The Word of God says it rains on the just and the unjust.
Yeah.
But I like what it says, love covers a multitude of sins.
Thank you.
That's just God's word. Like nobody else's love covers a multitude of sins. God looks beyond everything. I can leave my side of town and it be raining and go to the other side of town. And it don't look like a drop has fell, amen. But that's a just God. You know what? He know how to take that rain from the east side and put it on the west side. He's a good God, amen. That's the side effect that y'all need to understand. Love can fix some things in our heart. Love can fix some things in your home. That we may have life and have life more abundantly. It's so much about love that we can do, amen. It can get you going. But see, we look at all these other things, talking about some affections. He said, love. The love of God covers everything up. The love of God got you that job, that your qualifications didn't even do. That love of God got you that man. Just like the rest of y'all. I hate it, but you know what? I read all them side effects before I take anything. When I get down on this, I said, well, this is gonna happen to this. I don't think I really need it. I can deal with this one pain. Let me walk with this limp instead of having two limbs, amen. Sometimes you gotta really realize what the side effects are. But just more than half of us didn't realize that side effects of love. Y'all didn't know that, you know, we had to pay a price. But Jesus prayed that ultimate price. He died for us. He didn't have to do it, but he did. Even in the midst of thinking about you and I, he died on that old rugged cross. Paul was a good example of sacrifice. Paul, he persecuted Christians. That's what he did until he had a change in his life. His name was Saul, and got changed to Paul, and now Paul said, look, says there's a lot of things that will happen, but love never fails. Things will leave us, but love, it never leaves us. God's word said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. God's word reminds us, I love you. Even as a child, we learned a long time ago, the son, yes, Jesus loves me, because the Bible tells me so. Yes, Jesus loves me. I don't know about y'all, I remember that just like it was yesterday. To sing that song all the time, but it wasn't just a song, it got in my heart because I knew. Then nobody else see me but Jesus. He saw me when I was in my mess. He brought me. Well, let me talk to the demons, they probably know more. He brought us out of some places that we didn't have to be. It was his love. Some of them wicked said, Lord Jesus, get me through this. I'll never do it again. He brought us through it, and we did it again. It was love. It was a side effect. I don't know about y'all, but let me talk about me for a minute. He brought me from a mighty long way. You didn't see me when I had my fro. You didn't see me when I had my Trans Am. You didn't see me when I thought I was everything, but God kept me. His side effects. When I wanted to give up, his side effects kept me going. He kept me motivated each time. I don't know about y'all, but I thank God. I thank God for the side effects of love. Y'all sitting here like, is it really that good? Yeah. It is. Pastor on Wednesday, his message was, all of this for me? But this morning, I'm letting you know, yeah, you got side effects. It wasn't meant for you to look here, side effects. It happened. Because you showed up this morning as a side effect, amen. You get excited because I don't know what's wrong with them. Yeah, they're thinking about the side effects. They thinking about what God is going to do, what he's already done. He brought me from a mighty long way. I thank God for the side effects. Just like Fantasia, she started remembering things. I can't think, I can't operate because I got side effects. I got side effects every morning. Lord God made another thing. When it's raining, when the sun is shining, God is still good, amen. Even in the pandemic, God is still good, amen. I lost some loved ones, but God is still good. There's some side effects. I don't know about y'all, but if you ever visit someone in the hospital, we would go in and try to be cautious about, we didn't want to catch whatever they had. We would always take precautions, right? But there's some side effects. See, if you begin to pray for me, and I pray for you, there's some side effects. God's own heart. He has some side effects in his life, amen. We know David committed adultery. Not only that, David committed murder by having the woman's husband murdered. David here is a mess, right? But it was side effects that God looked on.
Love every one of y'all.
Ain't that good news? I love you. I love you. I love you. changed our language a little bit. We still got a little bit of stuff slipped sometimes. But God know how to keep your lips. He know how to change all that stuff. I don't know about y'all, but if you hang around mess, you're going to get in some mess. I don't know about y'all. I thank God that I know how to walk and watch where I'm walking so I don't step in no mess. Amen. But mess is all around us. Amen. But we have to be careful because there's some side effects. If you get into some mess and don't know it, you're going to take that mess into your house. Amen. I don't know about y'all, but when mess show up in my house, it start messing with some other stuff. Amen. I don't know about y'all, but one car can start acting up to the other car. All of a sudden, you go to the refrigerator, come to the stove. All kind of mess that can happen. I don't know. That's side effects. Amen. Y'all know how you turn your lights on, amen. We hit the switch, the light should come on. But sometimes we look at the light and hit the switch, it didn't come on. So the first thing we start looking at, when is the bulb blown? So we go, new bulb, there's a new bulb, and I hit the switch again, and the light still didn't come on. There's something wrong with me. That light should have came on. What should we be thinking to ourselves? I changed the bulb, I hit the switch. And then we said, well, I wonder. We're not electricians, so we start saying, I might have to call somebody else. Because they ain't sticking nothing else going on. But let me get one more bug. That might be a too bad bug. Let me get one more bug. So we try one more bug. And it happened to hit the switch, and the light comes on. And you say, what was that? Did I buy two bad bugs? Or what was it? And you realize, I don't know, but it's light there. So we can leave it alone, amen? Understand what's going on with this pandemic, but it's a side effect. God is changing the world in a mighty way. He's making us use technology that we've had for years and say, y'all better have been Zooming, y'all should have been Facebooking, y'all should have been doing the right things with this technology that I've given you. He said, I got it. I got your attention. So he said, that side effect you got going on. I don't know about y'all, but we've used our phone. And we look every time we look at our phone, we look at the Bible like we look at our phone. Yeah. The world would have a lot of different signs. Yeah. Things would flow a lot better. Yeah. I don't know about y'all. I like side effects. I like some of them, amen. Side effects of eating. Sometimes you can eat too much, amen. And we'll put you to sleep, amen. Sometimes side effects, even in the church, the word of God. You can't sleep at night, start reading the Bible, the devil will jump on you right here. He can run out of this thing. That's a side effect. Side effects of life. I don't know about y'all, but God is working with us in a mighty way. And he's telling you, you got to realize, you're not in control. As much as you want to be in control, you're not in control.
Right.
When he spoke to me, when he told me that, I want to control, I'm like, Lord, me, I thought, this is me, I run this! And no, you don't. If I don't want you to breathe, you can't breathe. I thank you, Lord, for another breath. Thank you, Lord, for another opportunity. Thank you for my aching pain that I can still say I will bless the Lord at all. And praise you up to Jesus, my oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let everybody praise you, magnify the Lord with me. Y'all need to get excited. Come to James here, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He didn't just stop right there. He said he shall provide all of my needs. I'm glad. The side effects when I look around. He provided when I look over at my neighbor's house and his grass is green and I wonder why mine's not green. He says, I got it. Just get out there and work in yours like he's working in his. Amen. God gives us these side effects. His word is warning. When Jesus wrote these
words, thank you, Lord.
He let us know.
Thank you, Lord.
It's not a whole lot. The word of God says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, believe in thy heart,
Lord,
that Jesus died and was raised from the dead.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, it's not a whole lot drawn out thing. I don't know about it. Some of us think we got to do all of this. The word of God tells us exactly what we got to do to get this love. This love is free. This love don't cost us nothing. He paid the price on Calvary for us. Judgment Hall. Did you see the side effect when the preacher was talking about how they put him on trial? But even he had when they carried his cross, did you see the side effects when they nailed him up and they raised him up and said, "Ah, oh, he's in the outro hall." Did you see the side effects? Oh, what they should have did, they should have lifted him up. But it reminded us the word of God said there was one on one thief on the left and one on the right. One said, "If you are who you say you are, save yourself and save us." But the one on the right, he said, "Look, I know who you are, and I believe who you are. Just remember me when you come into your paradise." That's what I'm saying this morning, y'all. It's time that you must remember me. Just don't forget about me, y'all. I thank you for looking behind my thoughts. I'm so happy this morning. I'm so happy this morning about side effects. I get joy when I think about it. When Paul began to write about love in chapter 13, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, he lets us know there are some things about love. And Paul really was a good writer. And he reminded us a great thing. Because in 13, Paul says, "Though I speak with tongues of men of angels and have not love, I have become a sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal." And he says, "If I have the gift of prophecy and understanding and all mystery and all knowledge, and have not faith, so that I can remove mountains, and have not love, I am nothing." This is Paul talking to us. And he says, "Hey, although I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be buried, and have not love, it profit me nothing." He goes on to say, "Love, love suffers long. Love is kind. Love envies not. Love bundles not itself. It's not puffed up. Does not behave itself unseemly. Seeks not her own. It is not easily provoked. Think no evil. Rejoice not in iniquity, but rejoice in the truth." It says, "Bear all things, believe all things, hopes all things, endure all things." Love never fails. But where there is prophecy, they shall fail. Where there is tongue, they shall cease. Where there is knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part and we prophesize in part. He goes on to let us know.
Thank you, Lord.
For we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now in part, but then shall I know, even as a man. And now abide faith, hope, love. These three, but the greatest is love. How is Paul telling you? The greatest. I'm glad God loves us. But you know what? I've always learned that's got to be a 50-50 love. Y'all remember Teddy P? Some of us Teddy P in your ass. Y'all, some of y'all still listen to that music. It's all right. I listen to it. I favorite son. I'm looking for a 50-50 love. Not a 70-30, not a 60-40. He wants a 50-50 love. That's 50 you give and I give. But you know what? I want 100. I want to give God my all. But I love it. But see, he don't want to give him a lot of love. Because that's easy. We need to show our love. And to show our love to God, we have to love ye one another.
Yes.
That's how we show love to God, by loving one another.
Yes.
I don't know about y'all, but I can't go around hating nobody. Amen. I might not like your hair, I might not like your clothes, I might not even like your car, but I gotta love you in spite of, and that love is, if it's you, that's you. I ain't mad at you.
Amen.
I ain't jealous of what you got or how you look, but what God has for you is you, and what he has for me. I know me and my wife have been married for a minute. I don't say how long it took. There's a lot of things we have in common that we didn't have in common. I start aching one place, next thing I know, she aching me. I'm like, how do we get the same aches? Because we've been hanging around too much. She watched this stuff on TV, got me watching this stuff on TV. We've been hanging around too much. I tell her, we need to get away from my house. We're getting too much of life. That's a side effect. Stop beginning to rub off on me, man. If you keep showing, showing up here.
Oh, yeah.
It's gonna be some solid.
Yeah.
I want to know it's all right. It's all right. We're gonna work through these things, amen.
Yeah.
It's gonna be some solid. If you would, rest on your feet.
Thank you, Lord.
Song says, something on the inside, working on the outside. Oh, what a change.